Amazon Music.
Guitar known
as, if you can look in there in the sound hole, is known as the VSA535 Cherry. It's actually based on, of course, the Gibson 535,
made by John Hornby Skewes, this guitar. Long since discontinued, so good luck in trying to find one. I actually found this by accident on eBay, looking for the two-tone version, the Tobacco Burst. This is a guitar they made back in 2011, 2012 time. Very short run, small numbers were made. This is, of course, unlike their current model that's got the offset horns. This is just a straight copy. Wilkinson hardware. It's pretty amazing finish for a Chinese-made guitar. I know there's a lot of debate about where these guitars are made. Some say Vietnam, some say China, but there you go. That confirms they are China. Wilkinson tulip style. Tuning heads, the deluxe. As I say, this is about 8 years old, this model. You can, probably not in this light, but there is a flame maple on the neck you can make out under that finish, and probably is a scarf joint neck, but because it's got the cherry finish on the top, you can't really make out if it is a single piece of wood or not. But yeah, fantastic finish on this guitar. Got a heel joint there, set neck.
Yeah, I found this on eBay just by accident. I'm always
looking for the version 1 of this guitar, which is the straight copy, on places like eBay, Gumtree, Amazon, Facebook, and they very rarely come up, and I've never actually seen a cherry red one, except last week I saw one and I bought it straight away. I wasn't going to quibble about the price. They're always so cheap anyway when these come up second hand. $220 I paid on eBay, paid for it straight away, hadn't even checked the guitar. With guitars like this you have to buy and then take a slight risk with them. You know they're decent quality anyway. I've got quite a few vintage guitars. You know, it may have fret wear, there's a risk there, but I just bought it straight off. A seller was based in south of England, so I got down there because they didn't want to post it. That's another thing you have to deal with. Some sellers don't want to post, so you have to be prepared to travel, and sometimes you have to be prepared to pay without actually even trying the guitar. That's unfortunately the world we live in with these guitars. There's so few of them around. They just go. If you don't buy them straight off, they just go. How much of a risk is it if it's £220? It's debatable, really, when you consider that this guitar is a tenth of the cost of an actual Gibson. And in my opinion, there's not a lot in it. It's worth taking the risk, in my opinion. That's why I did, because they're so rare. Version 1, I reckon they probably only made a few hundred of these before they stopped making them. As I say, I've been on the lookout for the tobacco burst two-tone and version, and this one came up. You can tell it's an early model, about the 2010-2011. As I say, it's got the inlays, the mother of pearl inlays and the flower inlay. They're all silkscreen now. Vintage haven't made a model with a mother of pearl for quite a few years. It's just a money saving option they've decided to go for. Wilkinson Path pickups, rosewood fretboard, but finish on it is amazing. Beautiful guitar, beautiful sounding, and caught, as I say, bought for peanuts, but they don't come up very often. This one is the first time I've seen a cherry red version of this guitar. It's the first one I've seen in two years of looking. That's how rare they are. So yeah, if you see one come along, you've got to buy it straight away. Hope you like the video.